It's gonna have to fall.
Okay, but this is about
it says, for God loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever believes in him shall not perish, right? Have everlasting life. Right? Now let's go up to verse 14, right? And what does verse 14 say? So even so, must the Son of Man get to who the world, and he calls Jesus Christ, right? So in the wilderness, who is in the world? Who's in the wilderness with Moses? The whole world in the wilderness with Moses.
Like there's something that we
was the whole world?
And I guess a lot.
Or was it Israel? So when it says that God gave his only begotten Son,
Chapter 1, verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel on this side Jordan, in the wilderness, in the plain over against the Red Sea.
So you see that Moses with the Israelites, right? Mm-hmm. Is he with the world? No. So when you read that, and it says that God so loved the world, you think that it's talking about world for some reason. Is it?
Yeah.
Hebrews 11 and 1. Let's go.
Chapter 11, verse 1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained good report. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God.
But the worlds, right? That's right. A singular, plural. Have you heard of the world of soccer? Or
sea world?
Or the world of baseball?
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Right, so you got to understand when it's talking world, in the context of what the scripture's talking about, you can't just say God so loved the world. That's when right. You read verses up, and you know that God was with the Israelites in the wilderness. So now that's Isaiah 45. Watch, I'm going to show you that the world is talking about the nation of Israel. It's going to say in the scriptures. You got it?
The book of Isaiah chapter 45 and 16. But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation.
Whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. We're about to say the same thing. Watch this.
Ye shall not be ashamed, nor be confounded.
World without end.
World without end. Ready to flip from the top.
But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation.
But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with the everlasting salvation, with the everlasting life.
That's right.
Read.
Ye shall not be ashamed, nor confounded. World without end.
See, gonna be ashamed, nor are we confounded by when we hear these false doctrines about the world. Read.
For thus said the Lord God that created the heavens, God himself that formed the earth and made it. He hath established it. He created it not in vain. He formed it to be inhabited. I am the Lord, and there is none else.
Watch this. You know Malachi 3 and 6, right? Right. He's the same to that. So did he ever come to Israel?
Yeah.
Matthew 15, one real quick. Because if you're going to say that it's for the world, and I showed you that that world was Israel in the Bible, he said that they shall not be ashamed world, a foreign world without end, a confounded world without end, right? Then how would he would have to change then? Because now you say that it's for the world.
This book of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent, but unto the lost sheep of Israel.
He said, but he is not sent, but only unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But now, when you know.
Okay, so explain this. John 10 and John 8, I forget which one is. This is other sheep which I have which are not of this fold. They must too go on to too. So,
like, there wasn't enough. I just showed you. Let's go to 1 Corinthians 10 and 2 then. We must see that they brought the law, statutes, and the commandments. That's what why did Israel get scattered to the Bible?
Yeah.
Why did they get so when they got scattered, why did they get scattered?
Because of their wickedness.
Because of their wickedness. So do you think God was saying they was his people when they were wicked?
Yeah,
so that's still is Israel still God's people when they were wicked?
Yeah.
Why would they be? What is the verse where it says that Elohim on me for they not my people? Is it Hosea?
Hosea 1:10.
Let's go to Hosea.
Sorry,
you got
yeah,
it right
go ahead, get out.
Yet the number of children of Israel shall be as the sea.
You see, before you look, you see, the sea walked out here again. Okay? Of who he is when we came over here on slave ships and got a heritage beat out of us, got called African Americans, and got called Hispanics. Now watch.
Which cannot be measured nor numbered, and it shall come to pass that in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there he said unto them, ye are sons of the living God.
There
it
is, right here before you. The place.
Ask him, where is that stated at? That he's quoting. Where is that stated at? That's stated in a book. Okay. If you were studying, if you come out to teach, then you could answer these questions. This is found in the book of what?
Which
so, books so were written in Greek?
How could you say that the Bible was written in Greek when the New Testament is new and the Old Testament is Paleo-Hebrew? So the Greek Testament doesn't even... Paleo was before that.
Right, perhaps there's some answers when I say the Bible and some New Testament. Well, if you're old, wouldn't it be mostly Hebrew?
What was Christ preaching from? The Old Testament, correct?
Christ has been speaking himself in Aramaic.
But what was he, would he be, would he be so, was he just,
let me
hear what is he from the New Testament or the Old?
Yeah.
Okay,
so.
Has been interpreted, we can go and look at the etymology of the word first, and we can look at the words now, and it actually is that word.
So, in other words, you are going to go into the King James, and you would find a piece of scripture, and you go back into the original Hebrew. The King James Version then be incorrect and the Hebrew Version be correct.
but they don't contradict each other.
Let me give you an example. In the 16th,
your understanding contradicts what the Bible already teaches. What you bear witness on is your own understanding.
That's right. That's right.
Not the understanding of the Lord. You got to understand that these things are not written, but only for a certain people.
That's right.
He showed his word unto Jacob, his laws and statutes unto Israel, and he didn't tell so with
any other nation.
You get gross interpretation, and now trying to somehow balance what your perception is. No, it doesn't work like that. We go back to the Chaldean lexicon, and I can tell you that the King James Version is the closest interpretation to what you have taught my people.
I was going to give you
because of all this amantis that you're telling me is what you're coerced. That's why I can take one word and take it, it can mean can and mean three other things. But yet you can go back to the Hebrew and it means one thing and one thing only.
That's right.
Give me the book of Ecclesiastes, the preface, and I'm going to show you what we learn because you don't understand this. Give me Ecclesiastes 1 and 1.
That is one and one.
There you go.
It's just passion.
All the wisdom come from the Lord and is with him forever.
That's right.
And the drops of rain and the days of eternity. Who can find out the height of heaven and the earth and the deep and wisdom. Wisdom having been before all things and the understanding of prudence from everlasting. The word of God is the word of God most high is the foundation of wisdom, and her ways are everlasting commandments. For the same things uttered in Hebrew and translated into another tongue have not the same force in them. Not only these things, but the law itself and the prophets and the rest of the books have no small difference.
So you have to understand, he's saying words that are interpreted from another language into this known language have not the same. You taking us when we come out here, you're taking us in another form.
Right.
This is what I was trying to tell you. He showed us to Jacob.
Right.
Because we come here excited. We put back at people that you like to watch us like that.
Right.
So now when I
y'all
come and bear witness in front of you,
over some music.
It's a little offensive. But I'm going to tell you like this. We understand those things. And you're trying to teach somebody who's trying to teach you. You asking a question?
Question,
are you trying to bear
about,
witness?
Okay.
And if it be witness, should you not bear witness? Correctly? Don't be afraid. He's not going to do nothing. That's the problem with this world. Y'all do these things. Your forefather came here. And I can hear them say the Mexicans, but they were here before the blacks came. Do you know that in that Bible, in 723 BCE, that these people were taken captive onto another land called Azure? Do you know where this land is at? Do you know that your people had that information and they took it to his people? Do you know that? Do you know that? Why can I say this? Give me 2 Ezra chapter 33. And then I want you to 45. And I'm going to prove something to you. Give me the Jewish encyclopedia on your phone. And I'm going to prove to you the Europeans. And the things that y'all have done. The things that y'all have done. The things y'all have manipulated and perverted. That's why you have the tone to come out here and try to whitewash something. But you're not going to blind the eyes of the prophet. Guess what? We come here in a different moment. We'll come and answer. And we'll answer.
Come on, baby.
Let me show you something.
Right.
2 Ezra 13. The Lord sent these people off in 723 BCE. It's what you're known as the Hispanics and the Indians here today. Read.
Come on, brother. Come on.
I need you back. Come on.
Those are the 12 tribes.
Remember, there's 12 tribes because he just verified that. There's 12 tribes.
Come on.
Come on,
brother.
The time of go see the king. Where?
Whom Solomon answered. The king
was the king of Assyria.
Check it out,
Well, actually started a little bit before that. We've been conquered. We were taken captive again, like the Bible said in what? Deuteronomy 28. That these things will be seeks to these people. You will know them because they will be a marker, a sign, a byword.
That's right.
A byword. We call beaners and Mexicans, beaners and red this and red that or something or another. We always have a label. We're always looked at such low beings in this world. But yet, y'all use us to build cities.
Amen.
You use it to gather and take our intelligence, because everything that was created here, from telephone to the light bulb, was created black or Hispanic. Matter of fact, now, not even those labels.
Your video games?
The children of Israel, the salt of this earth. You have a question on Mark, right? Right?
No.
Go ahead.
Luke,
right? Luke, Mark, whatever you said. I'm fixing to give you something.
Let me explain it first. What you said?
I just wanted to know, didn't you say that the kingdom of heaven is for everyone?
Acts 2:21. Let's find out. Acts.
Precept to the kings of Israel, Syria. This is 2 Kings 18:11. And the king of Assyria did carry away Israel unto Assyria.
So know that these Israelites that you were talking about, the Gentile people, we just proved in the book of Hosea that they were going to be taken away. Taken away captive. I just proved that there is evidence. How do I know this? Because it's not History Channel just released that there's cocaine in mummies. Where's cocaine indicative to? South America.
That's right.
Only.
Yeah, that's right.
So if these people, now all these people over here, we just proved to you in 2 Kings that they were taken away. The journey was 3 years. A year and a half there and a year and a half back.
This is Jeremiah 15. Therefore will I cast you out of this land into a land that ye know not.
So this is where we are. We're in a land that we know not. I want you to read to 19. This is what's going on today.
Amen. Have ye your fathers, and there shall ye serve other gods day and night.
And do we, are we not under Christianity? You know what Christianity is? That what they're saying, Jesus is not even the correct pictorial.
Amen. That's right.
And his name is not Jesus. They didn't come into the Bible. Excuse me, to the alphabet. It's a whip. 1600. And it's, guess what? Say this.
Yes.
Either way, you knew the truth and you're teaching my people.
Amen.
Because you knew the truth right now. Guess what? Your brother over there, I just want to have fun.
Amen.
He's teaching my people the false.
Amen.
The false. What we just read. Hold on. We're
following
something. It's not like that, but it is like that. Let me read it to you. I'm going to show you. Jump up to 19. No. And we understand. We're one to answer. We basketball like this. We just like this. We just like this.
Hey, guys. I'm going to show you all your questions from you.
I didn't do that.
Let's go. Read Jeremiah 16 and 19.
Okay.
Jeremiah 16
and 19. Well, the Mormons were here for a while, and y'all didn't say anything.
Hey. Oh, Lord.
Are we
in a fortress?
They can hear us. Is this library? The sidewalk is library. I'm an armed security officer myself.
I appreciate it.
I'm an armed security officer. I know this is public. I know, but I mean, to have us move when it's only, when it's
I just
city.
Want the customers to feel safe.
That's the whole point. I'm glad I got that. That's the whole point.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? The customers don't feel safe when they leave this.
Right. The Mormons are going.
They feel safe when they're anyway.
Right, yeah, the Mormons is okay. To come and say that's what we bring out the Bible. Good Lord. Had to shut it down.
They would send Jake to do they would too.
Shalom Israel, you see what happened? All peace. Kwam Yasharallah. Until next time.